Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah amma ba'd. In Surah Taha, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instructs, commands our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with the words, ba'da a'udhu billahi min ash-shaytani rajim, wa qur rabbi zidni ilma. Say, O my Lord, increase me in knowledge. Our ulama, rahimahumullah, they have pointed out that nowhere else in the Quran has Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instructed and commanded our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to ask him more of something, to grant him an increase in something other than in this place. And what is the increase that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instructs the Prophet to ask him for? It is an increase, it is an addition in knowledge. Brothers and sisters, this is because of the importance of knowledge. And this is not only the only place in the Quran or in the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam that we find praise and we find an encouragement to acquire knowledge. Because worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon ignorance is not what we do. We worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala based upon knowledge. That is the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And hence, like I said, there are many, many encouragements from him that we should be acquiring knowledge of the deen and continuing to acquire knowledge of the deen. Anas radiallahu anhu reports that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, for example, said, Talabul ilm faridatun ala kulli muslim. Seeking of knowledge is an obligation upon every single Muslim. Abu Darda radiallahu anhu narrates from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam a lengthy hadith in which he said, whoever sets out in order to acquire knowledge, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes the path to Jannah easy for that person. Muawiyah radiallahu anhu narrates another hadith in which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, مَنْ يُرِدِ اللَّهُ بِهِ خَيْرٍ يُفَقِّحُ فِي الدِّينِ. Whosoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala desires goodness for, wants to do good with, then he bestows him with understanding, fiqh, in the religion. Because understanding in the religion should lead to righteous actions, and righteous actions should lead one to the mercy and the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and ultimately the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, something I want to point out. Generally, when we talk about, or sometimes when we talk about, the importance of acquiring knowledge and learning the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it comes to our minds, or the connotations of it are that one has to become a scholar, or this is only for the scholars, it is only if you're going to abroad to a certain known university, or it's only if you can do the hifz of the Quran, or that you can memorize many a hadith, or you can speak Arabic, and so on and so forth. No, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the Prophet of Rahmah, he would not have made it an individual obligation, as Anas radiallahu anhu said, that seeking knowledge is an obligation upon every Muslim. Now, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam would never have said this if that was the case, because he was the Prophet of Rahmah and the deen is there to make things easy for us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants ease for us and does not want difficulty for us. So what does it mean that it's an obligation to acquire knowledge? Imam Baghawi rahimahullah, explaining the hadith of the obligation of knowledge, he says that this is knowledge of which there is no alternative. There's no other option other than to learn this knowledge, and that is knowing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In other words, learning about the Tawheed and the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his deserving of our worship, and what nullifies that worshipping of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is the knowledge of his oneness and his Tawheed, and he says it's the knowledge of the Nabuwa, the prophethood of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and to learn how to pray salah, and obviously with that would come how to make wudu correctly and so on and so forth. And he says indeed learning all of these things is an individual obligation, and a person is answerable and accountable for whether they did it right or wrong. So it's important that we learn these things. As for things that are voluntary knowledge, then we can leave that to the scholars, rahimahumullah. And if we go on a quest to acquire voluntary and supplementary knowledge, then that is highly praiseworthy indeed as well. Ibn Battal rahimahullah, in his commentary in Sahih al-Bukhari, commenting on the words of the hadith of Muawiyah radiallahu anhu, when he said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala whenever he wants to grant goodness to a person, he grants him understanding in the religion, he quotes something beautiful from Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu. He says, and I'm just going to summarize the meaning of what he's saying, that somebody called Umar ibn Umar a faqih. somebody who is firm in the understanding of the religion, is a scholar in that regard, regarding the halal and the haram of the religion. And Ibn Umar said to him, what faqih? Faqih is actually anybody, everybody is a faqih. And a faqih is really a person who is wary of their purpose in this dunya, who is aware of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who acts accordingly, who detaches themselves to the right degree from the world, and the person who desires the akhirah, desires the hereafter, the permanent, the eternal life. That is really the person who is a faqih. It's just a title. And Ali al-Qari, rahimahullah, he mentioned something very, very similar. Now, this is an incorrect understanding that, you know, a faqih, all these labels and the sheikh and whatever, etc., these are just labels. The true faqih, the true one with the true alim and true person who knows, is knowledgeable, is the one who acts upon that knowledge and is consistent in doing the deeds that are beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And another thing that I want to mention just at the end of this, brothers and sisters, is that our deen is, like I mentioned before, a deen which we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala based upon knowledge. And it's not about quantity of deeds necessarily, it's about the quality of the deeds. And the quality only comes in when the deeds are done based upon knowledge. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Mulk, الَّذِي خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. Allah said, He is the one who created death and life in order that He see who is best among you in deeds. Ibn Kathir rahimahullah points out beautifully that Allah said, Ahsanu amala and not aktharu amala. The best in deeds, and He didn't say the most in deeds, because it is the best of deeds that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is looking for. It's the best of deeds that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will acknowledge. And the best of deeds will come when they are based upon knowledge. They are based upon the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And when we don't acquire knowledge, when we don't try to learn how to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, shaitan seizes this opportunity. Shaitan seizes this opportunity and makes it sound and look like that deen is very, very difficult. When I was young, for example, and I'm sure many can agree with this, you know, many can relate to this. I was, for example, grew up when I was told that Salatul Isha was consisting of 17 raka'ah. Subhanallah, 17, and that puts you off. The reality is that puts you in a precipitous position and makes the deen very, very difficult. When you realize, subhanallah, the only thing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes fard is four rakat farz namaz of Isha. And there are sunan, and there are nawafil, and there is witr, etc. But we need to understand the differences between them. We need to have fiqh and understanding of this in order that it becomes easy for us. Same with the aspects of wudu, and same for aspects of other aspects of the religion. The deen indeed is easy. Like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said in the Quran, يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ بِكُمُ الْيُسْرِ. Allah desires ease for you. وَلَا يُرِيدُ بِكُمُ الْعُسْرِ. And not Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not want difficulty for you. So until we go and engage and we try to learn the deen itself, at least those things that are in fardu ayn, that individual obligation, then we will be in a very, very tricky situation when being held accountable on the Day of Judgment. Because if we haven't taken up the resources that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has provided us with, the Quran and the Sunnah, we will be answerable, and we will be under, you know, we are deluded by the shaitan in many, many aspects. So it's important that we acquire knowledge of the deen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make acquiring the knowledge of the deen easy for us. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as promised, make the path to Jannah easy for us on the way to that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our deeds. Jazakumullah khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.